everybody. My name is Tammy Friedrichs, and I am this year's chair of the Hastings Chamber. So I first of all want to thank you all for coming and supporting the chamber and being part of this fabulous event. So it's an honor for me to be able to be your MC tonight and to share with you this wonderful evening. We have a great space, great food, great desserts, so enjoy while I'm still talking here. So over the past year, over the years that the chamber's been going, this event has continued to grow, and I think we're at an all-time high this year, so that's great to have so many people coming out to celebrate tonight. It's a great example of Hastings recognizing local talent and finding support organizations. We're tasked with leading and promoting our business community, and we can't do that without your help. So we really appreciate all of you being here and the support that you lend for Hastings business and help us do our job at the chamber. Before we get started tonight, I'd like to recognize a few special guests in our audience who deserve to be recognized. First of all, Denny McNamara, could you stand, please? Where's Denny? Denny has served as a state representative in District 54B for the past 14 years. As a small business owner himself, Denny could easily relate to the challenges local businesses face. Members have often told us he is friendly, approachable, and a strong advocate for the business community, definitely. While in office, he was most active on the Environmental and Natural Resources Policy Committee, serving as committee chair in 2011 and 2015. Please join me in thanking Representative McNamara for his dedication and leadership in the legislature these past 14 years. Thank you, Denny. Would the rest of our elected officials please stand? I think we have a county commissioner and 2017 chair of Dakota County's Board of Commissioners, Mike Slavik. Where's Mike? Do we have Mayor Paul Hicks? I talked to Paul last night, and he said, if I'm not there, I'm busy with the Minsure bill. I'll be there as soon as I can. So we recognize and appreciate Mr. Paul Hicks, our mayor. We have Hastings City Council member Joe Balsonic. Lori Brocks. We have Tina Folch. I had the chance to meet Tina. Lisa Liefeld. Trevor Lund. And Mark Vaughn. Thank you for our elected officials. We also have Vermilion City Council member Aaron Rother. Where's Aaron? Thank you all for being here tonight. We're extremely grateful for your dedication as public servants, and we look forward to working with you in the future. Appreciate you being here. Thank you. Well, I want to take a few minutes to look backwards for our past year, some of the busy and exciting things we've been doing at the Hastings Chamber. Last year at this time, we introduced you to our new president, Christy Barse, and she's just been doing a fabulous job. So let's put our hands together for Christy. So some of the things we've been working on this past year, one of the top of the list is we launched a new, easy-to-navigate interactive website. Even for me, I went on the website, I could actually find what I was looking for, so it was fabulous. So if you haven't had a chance, check it out. It's just a great way to represent Hastings to whoever's looking at our website, so that's great. We've also launched a couple of new programs, the Lunch Mob, which is a great, fun opportunity for people to get together over the lunch hour, do some networking, make some connections. One of the things that's great about the Hastings Chamber is the way we welcome new people. And when I was new, there were many, many people that reached out to me and made me feel so welcome. And now we have an opportunity to do that with new people joining the Chamber and people that maybe haven't been active and are being active now. We also have our Lunch and Learns, which give great information about topics of importance in the business community. We've partnered with the Hastings Community TV on televising the candidate forum, so very good opportunity to get informed. And we've also had another successful Rivertown Days. Thank you to the weather folks who gave us great weather. We had some wonderful entertainment, a great time. It was just a really fun year, and we celebrated the National Park Centennial in connection with the Mississippi River. So that was a great opportunity to do that. This year we look forward again to a great Rivertown Days. We also had entertainment at the new Rotary Pavilion, so a great opportunity to really feature the pavilion. The Chamber Ambassadors, as always, are very busy visiting over 50 local businesses and promoting those visits by social media, local newspaper, and the Chamber newsletter. Our ambassadors, our board members, and our Chamber staff recognize several businesses who reinvested in Hastings. We have ribbon cuttings. Those are featured on our website, but we have an opportunity to go out and welcome businesses and do the ribbon cutting, which is really a fun event. So, in your program, you have a letter from me kind of outlining our future plans for the upcoming year in 2017. That's like the second to last page, so I just want to touch on a few highlights from that. Our theme this year is leadership, and leadership embodied in what we've termed Chamber First. We want you to think of the Chamber First when someone asks you for, hey, can you refer me to so-and-so? Can you refer me to someone who does blank? Can you refer me to someone who offers this service or this product? We want you to think of Chamber First. Give that referral to fellow Chamber members and then reciprocate back. So think of the Chamber First. Chamber First is out there supporting our members with some of the events that I talked about, the Lunch Mob, providing great opportunities to form relationships with people and really get to know your fellow members. Chamber First, we support our members in advocating and supporting Hastings businesses. We work together with local economic development. We work together with the city. Had a great opportunity to partner with them on many of the opportunities that are here in Hastings. We're thinking of the Chamber First in partnering with tourism. We have this year launched a tourism program. You may have read about it in the paper, but we're partnering with the University of Minnesota to do an assessment of Hastings tourism. What are our assets? How can we use those to promote tourism in Hastings? So I hope you take a look on our website, participate in the feedback. We're looking for lots of feedback to gather the data that we need to really boost tourism for Hastings, which helps businesses of all kinds, both tourism businesses as well as keeping a strong economy going here in Hastings. And of course, we always enjoy doing Rivertown Days. I think all of us who volunteer, and that's many, many of you. It's not possible to put on such a major event without the volunteers and the support. So I want to raise a hand and thank all of you who support Rivertown Days financially and with your time and with your feet. Thank you very much. I'm honored to also give special recognition to our retiring board members. These are people who take time out of their busy schedule to attend the meetings, to volunteer at events, and to be out there in the community promoting the chamber, and these are people that I've gotten to know working on the board, so I'm really been blessed to have them as part of my life and to get to know them. So I want to recognize each of our outgoing members. First, we have Mark Christensen. Mark is a broker and owner of Hastings Keystone Real Estate. He served on the board from 2013 to 2016 and was an active member in the Business Advocacy Committee, which is a very important arm of the chamber. He's a huge live music fan. I got to know Mark and his wife at some of the different events that we attended. And he's great about, you know, picking up extra shifts to volunteer at the Rivertown Days. And also, I've enjoyed the opportunity to get to know Mark. He wasn't able to make it here, but let's give a hand to thank Mark for his contributions. Next, we have Noreen Bishop. She is the owner of Emily's Bakery and Deli. And also served on the board from 2013 to 2015. She was on the Communication Task Force, which set in place the plans for the new chamber website, which has just been a huge undertaking and is so cool now. She's been involved in the upcoming tourism project, including involvement on the new website, which will house tourism separately from the chamber once we get it all going again. She served as a strong voice for our business community on the Business Advocacy Committee and dedicated many volunteer hours to Rivertown Days. The delicious desserts on your table are courtesy of Noreen at Emily's Bakery, and just a little small sampling of the wonderful food available to you at Emily's Bakery. Emily's Bakery has been a landmark in Hastings for over 100 years. That's pretty amazing. Very amazing. We're very grateful to Noreen. She was able to offer her expertise as a longtime local business and to help shape the program of our work for the Chamber of Commerce. Thank you, Noreen. It's been great to have you on the board. Last, I want to recognize Jill Reagan-Scully. She wasn't able to make it tonight, but she served as our chair last year. She's the owner of Impressive Windows and Interior, and she's been a member of the Chamber Board since 2010. That's a long time. And she served as our board chair last year. She's an entrepreneur in her business. She started out of her home, and she has understood the importance of networking. I really got to know Jill, and she's always talking to people and networking. Under her leadership, two new chamber events were formed, the monthly lunch mobs, which I talked about earlier, and the chamber lunch and learns. Her laid-back management style encouraged members to get involved and to have their voices heard. We're going to please join me in a round of applause and thanking retiring board members and our past chair, Jill. We truly value the time and expertise that they brought to the board. Thank you very much. On to the next part of the program. We need Christy here. We're going to have an opportunity to recognize our special guests at tonight's annual dinner. Christy.
Hi, everyone. This is a great turnout. Holy cow. I think we have 50 more people from last year, which was my first gala. As you remember, I think I had started just a couple months before our annual dinner last year. So it's my second time around, and it's still my favorite event. So thank you all for being here. We are going to kick off the Community Award portion of our ceremony, starting with Educator of the Year. Although they come at different times in our lives and in various forms, we all have them. Mentors, coaches, advisors, and teachers. Those individuals who provide that perfect combination of support and guidance to help us grow and ultimately succeed. Kathy Gleick has taught religion at St. Elizabeth Ann Seton School for over 30 years. Her numerous nominations for Educator of the Year stood out to our executive committee this time around, not only because of her accomplishments, but because of who was submitting them. Many parents who had Kathy Gleick when they were younger are now having the pleasure of watching their students be taught by heart as well. Different from math or history, religion is a subject that provokes something sometimes difficult or confrontational questions, excuse me. But Kathy's compassionate approach to education provides a safe environment for her students, promoting individuality and confidence. Once again, Hastings Community TV has put together fantastic videos of our award recipients, so let's take a look at Kathy in action.
She's just a really good teacher.
It's just a great time being in her class. It's like the light of my day when I come in here and have a great time and then go back to classes where you read out of a textbook.
She's really quirky and fun and at the weirdest times, and I just love her.
She's so enthusiastic, and she wants to make the class more like different from all the other classes so that we have fun at the same time.
She has this feeling with the class that it's a big family, and the kids just respect her.
My name is Kathy Gleick. I teach middle school at St. Elizabeth Ann Seton Catholic School in Hastings. So teaching middle schoolers, you have to be very flexible and stern with the look.
If you're like out of line or whatever, she will literally give you the look and she'll like see into your soul and she does it when you're out of line, so that's one way she keeps us in line.
I've gotten that a couple times. So.
But they know I love them behind that look. So they're not gonna do anything for me if they don't know I love them and respect them and care about them. I always wanted my kids' teachers, like if they were out on a field trip, to treat my kid like their own, like they're gonna watch my kid at the zoo exactly like they'd watch their own. And I want to assure parents that's how things are here too. We care for them as if they were ours, because you give them to us 8 hours a day. And you have a right to expect that they're safe and challenged at all times.
Please welcome Ms. Kathy Gleick to the stage.
Wow. Good evening. My name's Kathy Gleick, and I'm a teacher. It wasn't what I planned to do. In fact, it's the only thing I thought I couldn't or wouldn't do, and boldly announced that to all who asked. I was fortunate enough to be educated at schools run by the Christian Brothers, whose founder, St. John Baptist de La Salle, is patron saint of teachers. He's quoted as saying of teachers, "God has chosen you to do his work, and God has chosen you to make him known to others." In college, I was guided by the brothers to think about teaching as a career. I trusted my mentors that they saw something in me that I did not see in myself. That's what good teachers do. They see potential in their students that they cannot fathom themselves. They encourage them to find the path God has chosen for them. And it's only in looking back that I'm able to see God's hand working through my teachers. And anyone who knows me knows I'm a teacher to the very core. I learned the art of teaching by watching some amazing people as a very young teacher. Women like past winners of this very award, Ona Gabriel, Darlene Jasperson. I stood in awe of them every day for many years and thought, perhaps someday I'll be a fraction of the teacher they were. They were masters of their craft, and I wanted to be just like them. Receiving this award is not only a reflection of my efforts, but a reflection on those with whom I'm blessed to work side by side every single day. Thanks for being here. For over 30 years, I've worked with and been supported by fellow teachers and principals who have made it possible to live and work the mission of our school. I've taught next door to and across the hall from women who work their magic with middle schoolers every single day. They have my back and I have theirs, and I'm blessed to call them friends. Hastings has been my home since 1983. It's where my husband Peter and I chose to raise our family. It is where our daughters, Mary and Elizabeth and Anne, were educated and launched on the path that God has chosen for them. We did not raise these women by ourselves. We had a whole building full of women and men, some of them here tonight, who loved them, right, girls? Guided them and challenged them. They celebrated with them through their triumphs and were with them in their struggles. They saw things in our children they did not see themselves. They loved our girls almost as much as their father and I do, because that's what teachers do. As a community, we're fortunate to have an outstanding school system, public and private. A healthy community educates its children and supports its schools. I'm honored to represent this community and proud of the good work all of us do on behalf of the children of Hastings. Thank you to the Hastings Chamber of Commerce, as well as the good people who nominated for this amazing distinction. Congratulations to Barb and Dan Massman and KDWA, as well as Cindy Thurie-Smith. I'm proud to stand alongside you in this distinction tonight. Thank you to Father Dave and Seas Parish for supporting our school financially and spiritually for well over 100 years. Thank you to my principal, Tim Sullivan, and Rita Humbert, former principal at Seas, for challenging me and my colleagues to strive for excellence in all that we do at school. You make us better teachers and better people. I'd like to thank my family, Mary and Elizabeth and Anne. I know it wasn't always easy to be the teacher's kid. I was honored to be your teacher. I'm most proud of just being your mom. You're my best work. And last, to my husband, Peter, the guy behind the camera, an award-winning teacher himself for over 30 years. Thanks for your unconditional love and constant support of me and our girls. Thank you.
All right, that was a tearjerker. This up. Okay, moving on to Volunteer of the Year. Cindy, there we go. As many of you know, the most fulfilling way to volunteer is to utilize our talents and skill sets as a means of giving back. Cindy Thurie-Smith is a gifted quilter, historian, and environmentalist. She's best known for her volunteer work as curator of the Pioneer Room at City Hall, where city staff, student groups, and visitors tap into her extensive mind or extensive knowledge of the history of Hastings. She's also a very gifted quilter and teaches nationally to groups interested in learning the craft. She has made six quilts for the local LaDuke Mansion. And as many of you know, these are not standard quilts. They are extremely beautiful and intricate designs. When she is not at the LaDuke or at City Hall, you'll find Cindy outside. She's an active volunteer with the Hastings Environmental Protectors, Carpenter Nature Center, Friends of the Mississippi, and a various amount of other groups. I could actually read you this list, but it would take all night. The majority of her nomination forms came at 5 or 6 pages long. She is involved in a numerous amount of activities in Hastings. And I'm gonna let the video speak for that.
My name is Cynthia Thurie-Smith, and I'm the curator here at the City of Hastings Pioneer Room, which is our historical records room. We preserve the history of the town and the people and the government infrastructure that is in the City of Hastings. I saw this advertisement in the Hastings paper, and I remember, because I was reading the want ads all the time, and I said to my husband, I said, "Listen to this one." It asked for someone with library experience, which I had, textile experience, which I had, office experience, which I had. Who the heck is going to have all those weird qualifications? And he said, "Well, you do. There's so many things that take, 2 minutes, 5 minutes, 3 hours. I like being able to get something accomplished every day. I really like being exposed to a lot of the art that I come across all the time. We're doing a little research now on women's suffrage. Look at that beautiful suffrage poster. There's so many funny stories and so many sad stories and so many stories of accomplishments and things not accomplished that you can always identify with somebody that has come before you. And I think we also need to be grateful for those people who came before us, because so many of the things that we take for granted, our parents or our grandparents didn't have. My grandmother couldn't vote most of her life, but I can vote and I will vote. And I'm not a real big fan of people who think, "I did everything on my own." Well, you had a lot of help. A lot of other people have helped establish how you got your education, how you got your health care, so you're healthy. We all owe a debt. Boy, is that getting heavy.
Please welcome Volunteer of the Year, Cindy Thurie-Smith, to the stage.
While that was being filmed, my helpful volunteers were sitting in the back of the room behind the camera making shoveling motions. But you got to take what volunteers you can get. My husband and I came to Hastings in 1983,
And we had lived at several other towns, Mankato and Roseville and Rochester. But when we moved to Hastings, we immediately noticed the amenities. They had such an extensive park system. And you had a nice library and a bakery. Let's not forget the bakery. And a local television station and a local radio station and a local newspaper. And so it wasn't too long. It was only 2 years before we bought a house and we settled down. Well, then in 2002, as I mentioned in the video, I came across this strange advertisement for a position at City Hall. And I went into interview and I got the job. And I really think Dick Darso gave me the job because I walked in the room and I said, oh, I have that, I have that, I have that. And I used those cookbooks from King Midas. And I think that's he was impressed with that. So I applied for the position and I got it. And I want to thank the city of Hastings for having the foresight to realize that Hastings was an interesting place and had good stories to tell, and our history should be protected and preserved. From that time on, which was 2002, and for many years afterwards, Hastings was the only city in Minnesota that had a paid historian position. And the position was introduced to me, and it allowed me to work with some very wonderful people. I call them the Fab Four: Hazel Jacobson Thiel and her wonderful collection of artifacts, Ethel Thieling and her book collection, Bob Olson and his genealogical records, and Dick Darso and his wonderful encyclopedic knowledge of the town. Now, many of you knew Dick Darso, and in addition to organizing the Pioneer Room, he was such a wonderful example on the correct way to research and find all those hidden stories. He was certainly willing to share his knowledge and encourage anyone who stopped into the Pioneer Room and had questions. Because I enjoyed the work so much and the people in the Pioneer Room and at City Hall, I continued to volunteer down there one day a week after the curator position was discontinued. Dick and Ethel and Hazel are no longer with us, but they certainly made an impact on Hastings and on me. I am thankful they all lived to see the opening of the LeDuc House to the public. I have been lucky enough to have several steady volunteers help me in the Pioneer Room, especially Shirley DeLaska, Heidi Langenfeld, and Judy Slink. We keep finding interesting things every week, fun stories about the people and the businesses and how the town grew. When the LeDuc House opened up in 2005, it didn't have a lot of furnishings. Some of you may remember it didn't have any. With the history of needlework by Mrs. LeDuc and her daughters, I knew that we had to have a quilt collection for the LeDuc House. And I volunteered to organize 6 group quilts to be sewn for display at the house. I figured at most it would take 6 years because we'd have so many people, we'd have over a dozen people working on each quilt. But what I didn't take into account was trying to get a dozen women to sew everything on time. It would be kind of like herding chickens. So I just finished the last one in December of 2016, and they're all done. And I want to thank the staff at the LeDuc House for their patience and their appreciation. Never once did they say, when is that coming? When is it going to be done? Not once. Another thing my husband and I appreciate about Hastings is its beautiful environment. We have enjoyed the parks and the riverfront and the bird life all around us, and we found many like-minded citizens who want to protect this area. Lucky for us all, Dakota County and the city of Hastings are also interested in protecting our beautiful city. All in all, this has been a good place to live, and I am happy to help where I can, and I thank you very much for this award.
Moving on to a very, very special business. For over 50 years, our local radio station, KDWA, has had the AM station 1460. This past year, owner Dan Massman and his team saw an opportunity to secure or apply and secure for an FM station 97.7. On top of securing that new station, he doubled his sales staff and moved to a new location across the street. This gave him the opportunity to not only improve on their shopping show, but promote staff from within. 25 years ago, Dan became the owner of KDWA. And since then, we have seen a drastic change in the entertainment. It's not only our local news station, but our entertainment station, which covers our sports. Many of you who know Dan know that there are few activities within Hastings or community organizations that he's not involved in. And I'm going to let the video just speak for itself, so let's watch the video.
So, how was your Christmas, 007?
It was okay.
Good. Did the judge, did he treat you okay?
He did.
Okay, because if not, we'll come and visit.
He made me some chicken noodle soup.
Oh, did he? Oh, that was nice.
That's really nice. Drive by any time. I can tell you what office Dan's is, and the light is always on. He's here a lot because owning your own business is a hard thing to do in this economy in particular, and he has done a great job of it.
It's just a caring, great place to work, and it starts with the big guy in that office right over there, so definitely a great guy to work for.
The husband. Well, Dan is very understanding, very caring. He listens to me, even though he doesn't want to sometimes.
I'm Dan Massman, owner and operator of KDWA AM 1460, FM 97.7. We're a local station covering Hastings and Prescott. We specialize in local news as it happens and sports as it happens. And of course, if folks have community events and public service announcements, we're here.
We're trying to be Hastings Station. KDWA is Hastings Radio Station, and I think we take a lot of pride in that. We've done a better and better job, I think, every year of accomplishing that goal.
Every single day is new, but I think the reason that is continued for, 25 years under Dan and Barb, and then before that, 53 years, is we try to serve our local market, do it the best we can, try to bring all of that together. And I think that cohesiveness is the reason for the success.
We'll actually get to know people. And then Barb and Dan, of course, being here for so long, they kind of have a little bit of a system and they'll guide people along with it. It's unlike any other radio station.
You know, we've been blessed to work at something we love to do. And, have we worked a day in our life? We've worked a lot of hard days. I mean, I tell people, they say, what's your key success to a business? And I say, well, it's not bad. You just work part-time, 12 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Please welcome Dan Massman to the stage.
Boy, I'm humbled. What can you say? I want to thank, I find it a privilege to be on the same stage as somebody I've known for 30 years, Kathy Gleick. We talk about the shopping show. We have close to 6,000 numbers, and Kathy reminded me the other day, she's 185. She's been with us for a long time. Also, thank you to Cindy Thury-Smith for Volunteer of the Year. Both of you have changed our community, and you changed it for the best. What a blessing to know both of you. I also want to say thank you to the Hastings Chamber Board, the directors, President Christy Barse, for the 2017 Business of the Year privilege. Christy, I don't know if you realize it or not, but you were able to do something that no other president has been able to do in over 25 years. We were so shocked, you rendered us speechless. For a short while, but you tried and you succeeded. We were very surprised and honored. I'm only here to accept it as a member of the staff. it isn't just Dan Massman, it's all of our employees, all of the hard people and the work that they've done throughout the years. Thank you to all the businesses out here that I see that have trusted us to get the word out about your business and or service through those decades. We take it very seriously, and we'll continue to work hard to earn that trust. A history of KDWA, it had humbling beginnings as it went on the air October 1st of 1963. It was licensed with the FCC as a daytime-only station, meaning it went on the air at sunrise and went off again at sunset. Now, in the summer, that wasn't bad, but you get to this time of the year, and it meant going on the air at 7 a.m. and off at 4 p.m. I remember as a kid being a DJ there, and all we did in December was play commercials. Didn't have enough time to be on the air otherwise. Wasn't a lot of time. We bought the station, my wife and I, in October 1st of 1991. Having done some research, we learned that the FCC was going to do something that they hadn't done at all, and that was give some of the daytime-only radio stations a chance to apply for a very low-powered nighttime coverage, at just enough to cover the city of Hastings. So we bought the station, we did an engineering study, applied, and were granted the low nighttime power. That allowed us to do something that a lot of communities can't do, and that's cover sporting events, news, and of course weather in the evening and overnights. A huge addition for the radio station and community that we're so fortunate to serve. But the FCC, being a government entity, stopped that process after just a few months of doing it. However, any station that received permission to broadcast at night was grandfathered in. Wow, were we lucky. It wouldn't be until just recently, just the last few years, that they realized they had made a huge mistake and they should have allowed all small market radio stations to have nighttime power. But it was too late for a lot of them. They didn't make it. Hastings was never on the radar to have an FM station because we're considered part of the FCC's Twin Cities region. So the big boys, they've gobbled up all the FM signals. We didn't have the millions of dollars to buy one, so we just sat back. Fast forward to January of 2016, and the FCC came to a conclusion that they should help some of these mom and pop stations if they're ever going to survive. And they said, we had heard that they were going to allow them to apply for small FM stations. Well, we immediately made some call to some engineers, found a couple of frequencies that would fit in Hastings, hired attorneys, and of course you have to hire them out of Washington, D.C., and were able to obtain an FM signal. To this day, there's no longer any. It was a one-time chance, and we got it. You know, as a small business owner, you often wonder, you work hard, you see results, but are we on the right track? That was answered to us in about the late 1996, 1997, when we were contacted by the Mall of America. And they were saying that they had done a lot of research in the Hastings area, and KDWA came up numerous times because of their local news, sports, shopping show coverage, and community events. And they wanted to do business with us, which they have to this very day. They still do. Now, they are in the business, what we call, not lightweights. They know a little bit about what they're doing. So we felt we were on the right track. We feel, too, also to be successful in life, you have to have strong faith, first of all. You have to have a strong family, and you have to have good worker ethics and workers that share the same vision you do. Faith is a very important part of our business. We try and treat our employees, business partners, and listeners the way we would like to be treated. We broadcast over 9 church services a week. Kathy Gleick reminded me her and her kids used to do the radio rosary in the car every night at 6 o'clock. I guess Mom forced you to do it. I'm sorry. Just recently, we added St. John the Baptist Catholic Church in Vermilion to our broadcast schedule. The pastor, Father Cole, at St. John, along with his parish, are so full of joy and warmth. And why wouldn't you listen? Pastor Cole, along with other area ministers, do monthly shows on KDWA AM and FM. Through the decades, KDWA has been a training ground for broadcasters of all ages. For example, one of our news directors went on to be a longtime successful news anchor at a TV station in Austin, Minnesota. Another to this day still works for KSTP. Another runs a media center at the state capitol. Even the youth of Hastings have found KDWA to be a welcoming station to train at. Just recently, again, one of Mrs. Gleick's students, a lot of years ago, by the name of Reggie Bauer, worked at us with us starting at the age of 14. He now works at 100,000-watt music station, an iHeart music station, largest radio group in the world in Des Moines, Iowa. A story that's also worth mentioning is we've even had politicians get their start at KDWA. In the early years, we had a news director. His name was Mike Oskop. He was also a state representative. He did a monthly show on politics, which he brought in some of his friends, two of his representatives, on a monthly basis for about a year and a half. One representative from, I believe, was from Anoka area, another from South St. Paul. They learned their radio skills on, and they moved on up in the political ladder, using those skills dealing with the media. One of the guys' name was Charlie Weaver, the other was Tim Pawlenty. Anytime Tim was in Hastings, he stopped in, talked with us, and anytime we needed a comment, he'd call us back immediately, even from his car, his cell phone. In fact, one time his wife Mary was in the station doing a show for one of her causes. And of course, the state patrol always drove them around and watched them, guarded them. And the state patrol approached me one day and he said, "Can I ask you a question?" I said, "Well, okay, but isn't the standard answer I didn't do it?" He chuckled and said, "Why is it that Governor Pawlenty has a list of media that he'll talk to right away?" And with a puzzled look on his face, he said, "KDWA radio is in the top three, along with CCO and KSTP. We beat out KMSP and CARE 11. This time I chuckled and I explained the story to him. He said, that's it. Family is really important. This business has been a family business. I wouldn't be standing here if it wasn't. Many, many hardworking, devoted people. It's been a real blessing having my wife, Barbara, work with me side by side through all these decades, through the high points and through the low points. If you own a business, you know what I mean. And yes, I know it's hard to believe, but I may not have always been the easiest person to live with. But her love and our love for each other has lent us to endure. So thank you, Barbara. Tara, I want to say thank you to you, who works full-time during the week, yet she comes in every Saturday, because Elizabeth had to grow up. And she comes in every Saturday, works. I want to say thank you. Our grandchildren, Zach, Ben, and Cassandra, literally grew up on the radio station. From Zach and Ben, who did the shopping show with me, we heard them grow up on the radio. When they had their little kids' voices, then, I call them the squeaking years, that thing called puberty set in, and then they became young men that we're all proud of. Thank you. Cassandra improved her, I really think she improved her reading skills because of all those times she'd come in and she'd read those shopping show descriptions, and I'd have to whisper to her the right words. But she endured it, and she's much better for it. Thank you, Cassandra. It really takes a lot to be successful in business, life, and nothing beats family. Brian, my son, who would call me up and say, "Hey, let's go to lunch, Dad. It really sounds good." I'd say, "Where do you think we should go?" He'd say, "How about Superior?" And I'd go, "Wisconsin?" And you see, he's a pilot, and we'd take the afternoon and go to lunch. Now, we've done this many times, and each time I'm known to forget something, like either my prescription sunglasses, car keys, and at the restaurant or airport, I don't know. We're having such a good time, I'd forget something. Well, you see, Brian's also a police officer who usually has my back. And being a good police officer, he usually solved the mystery. He'd find out where the heck I left my glasses or my keys. And, well, he recently informed me that from now on, if we go to lunch, he's going to do two things for me. He's got my back, okay? He's going to buy me a chain to chain my keys to my belt. He's going to buy me one of those things you put around your glasses so it hangs around your neck so that I won't lose those. Well, Brian, really? But thanks for always having my back. Also, thank you to Patrick and Emily who are here. Thank you for taking the night. Kristen and Riley, Mark and Stacy for attending tonight. And oh, Riley, by the way, she's the young one over there. I'm betting as a young girl, you probably had something better to do than listen to Grandpa talk all night. Good for you. You're a great young granddaughter. At work, we've been successful because of the many loyal, hardworking, devoted people through the years, like Mo McNary. She's been with us for over 22 years. She's the birthday lady. She does all those in-depths around the area with the people, with the stories to tell. She gets them to tell them. And we've been thinking, you know, would Mo ever like to move on? But we're not ever going to ask her because of all the things she's seen and heard through all those years. But what a blessing you've been, Mo. Thank you. KDWA Sports Director Nick Tuckner, who isn't here tonight. You heard him in there. He always calls me Chief. I don't get it. But he said, Chief, don't you know I got a hockey game tonight? And nobody else can do it. And that's the devotion Nick has. Over 15 years of covering sports with us. Just 2 weeks ago, Nick himself won the Silent Raider Award. Now, I've asked Nick, I have to confess, I really don't understand what a silent award and Nick have to do with one another. But we're still really proud of him. He does a great job. And he always tells me the stories of the many schools that he goes to in our conference, and the athletic directors and the parents are just amazed. Hastings has a live radio station? Both AM and FM, by the way, just in case. I want to thank Jeff Wilson, our tech computer person, over 12 years. I don't know how many times I've had to make a call to Jeff, day, night, something went down, weekends, but Jeff is always there, and he always solves a problem. He always keeps in mind something that I say to him. As a small business, we got a budget, Jeff. He always solves it and comes in under the budget. Thank you, Jeff. Marta Holtz, who you saw here, she had an accident just a couple days ago and broke her nose. Our sales manager for over 10 years of service. Marta has one of those rare talents of being able, like I say, to sell sand to anybody in the middle of the desert. And that's how it works. Marta and her crew, Jerry and all over there, thank you for all you've done. Tom Thone, our engineer, who isn't here tonight, he's our transmission and auto engineer, over 23 years. Our current news director, Kelly Casey, and her great devotion to news. Her son, Cole, who's, by the way, is the official weather statistician for KDWA, and he keeps our front lawn looking like a golf course during the summer months. Thank you both. Haley Pottinger, who answers the phone, greets the listeners with a smile. Thank you. It takes a lot of people to get these awards. It really does. And then our longtime programs that we've had on. Superintendent of Schools, Tim Collins, Coach Augie O'Brien. Some of you probably know both of them. And they've been doing that show for over 14 years, keeping the community up to date on school events. I want to thank them both. Mike Dimmick, who has been coming in every Monday for 15 years, including holidays, to talk about NASCAR racing and snowmobiling. Thank you, Mike. By the way, your tie looks great. He was concerned. He hasn't had a tie, but it looks great. So when you see him, thank him. Finally, if you folks that are small business owners, you probably know what I'm about to say here. How many times have you been asked, boy, it must be great owning a small business. You can set your own hours, work your own days, do what you want. Anybody ever heard that? And I just like to say, I always say to them, my standard response is they've never walked the halls of their homes at night or walking their business thinking, you know, knowing what it's like to make a payroll. I have one response for them. Well, when you own a small business, you better love what you are doing. You better have a dedicated family. You better have a devoted workforce. Because those part-time hours you're going to work, well, you heard it up there. They're only 12 hours a day, 7 days a week. What do you do with the rest of the time? I've truly been blessed to work in a career that I love, having a loving family that understands the sacrifices that you have to have owning a small business, and a community that is second to none, plus great employees that share the dream. Tonight is yet another example. Stanley Hubbard, a great broadcaster, once said, just serve your community, and your community will serve you. No truer words. Thank you, and God bless you all from all of us at KDWA.
Okay, just a couple of quick announcements. The amazing videos tonight, I want to say thank you to Kurt and Tom at the Hastings Community TV for putting them on, and they will be on their Facebook page starting tomorrow morning, so check them out. Thank you. And lastly, I just want to say, if you take away one thing tonight, please take a mental picture of this room and all the people that are in it. And I'm going to echo something that Dan has to say, that as a small business or a large business, there's going to be ups and downs. But look to this room and look to that mental picture as your support system, because we're all in it together. We're all here to support each other in the good times and in the bad. So please make sure to reach out to us at the chamber staff and to each other and be reminded of this enormous group of people that are here to support you in your success. Okay, everyone, that's our program. Thank you so much for being here. For those who took the shuttle, it will be arriving at 9:15 if you want to board it. I think we all know who those people are in the room. And have a drink, gamble, have fun, and have a great weekend.